Hello everyone, welcome to Arcaster Science, and today I am back again with yet another new video. And in this video I will discuss the monthly horoscope for the month of June 2021 for the sign of Aries. And as usual, if you are new to this channel, tap onto the subscribe button, click onto the notification bell icon so that every time I make a new video you get notified instantly. And now without losing a single moment, come let us see the monthly horoscope for the sign of Aries for the month of June 2021.
So for the Aries people, your Lagna Lord Mars will be transiting through your 4th house of happiness, home, mental peace. And understanding the significance of the planet Mars transiting through your 4th house, it is getting debilitated during this transit, specifically when it is transiting through the sign of Cancer. And since it is transiting through the 4th house, it is also losing its Digbal. So this can lead to some disputes or conflicts at your homely environment, the place where you live in. It can also signify some kind of mental anxiety or lack of happiness index. Some chances of dispute at your marital life with your spouse, wife or husband, some conflicts with business partners, because the fourth aspect of Mars will be on the seventh house. Now since Mars will also aspect the 10th house, there can be some opposition to your authority, to your boss. So you have to take care regarding these things. Although there will be an aspect of Jupiter on the 7th house, that is the 9th aspect of Jupiter on the 7th house, which will act as a divine blessing, which will protect from all the problems in your married life. But still, since Mars is getting debilitated, you have to be very careful regarding any kind of miscommunication or how you try to communicate with your spouse or business partners. You have to become very much compromising regarding any decision making, because you have to give importance to the opinion of the other people also. You have to try to listen rather than act superficially, or rather than act in a very harsh way. In your second house, Mercury is getting retrograde, Sun, Rahu, all are transiting through your second house of Taurus, which is becoming very prominent during this time, this month of June. So any decision regarding your wealth, finance or investment should be done very carefully. Specifically, there should be double checking regarding any decision regarding to your finance. Because since Mercury is getting retrograde and it is also the house of your speech, so whatever you speak, whatever how you communicate with your family members or any person in general has to be done very carefully, because since Sun and Rahu are transiting together, so out of your ego, out of your arrogance or ignorance, you may speak something, you may say something, or you can take some decision regarding your wealth or finance out of your some elusive mindset or ego. Later on you may repent, you may regret that you should have done it with proper precision and care. So before so it's better to check it properly than to repent later on. So these are the things which has to be taken care of. Another important factor is that on 10th of June, there is going to be a solar eclipse on the second house for the Aries people. So this becomes very important, specifically related to your speech, family, your wealth, finance and investment. On 15th of June, Sun will be transiting to the sign of Gemini in your third house. That time your focus towards your hobbies, towards your actions and efforts will become much more focused and concentrated. That time the results given by Sun will be much more good and prominent. And on 22nd of June, Mercury is coming out of retrograde. So that time you can get much good insights regarding your investment, wealth and finance. So these are the things which can be understood through the second house for the Aries people for the month of June. In the third house, Venus is transiting, and here this transit of Venus through your third house in the sign of Gemini will be far more good, because Venus is your second and seventh lord, and that means you will get lot of support from your family and spouse, putting forward to your efforts and actions towards your artistic abilities and hobbies. Suppose if you are someone who likes to do painting, singing, dancing, performing arts like drama, theaters, then this is a very good time to go through it, because it will not only enhance your capabilities, but it can also lead to final success. And as soon as Sun will also enter the sign of Gemini, then Sun and Venus together will actually take you towards the much more towards the media. That means performing arts will become much more prominent that times. So people may know you, people may recognize you by your talents. So this can be a very good time for your hobbies and actions, specifically when Venus is transiting through your third house. Jupiter, as usual, will be transiting through your 11th house of gains, which will actually give you gains from various sources. And Jupiter being a very great benefic transiting through your 11th house, not only making a dhan yoga, but also it is enhancing your luck and prosperity through the gains in your life. It will be very beneficial as far as your creative self-expression is concerned, your creative talents and hobbies are concerned. Your relationship with your progeny, children, will be very good. If you are a student, if you are studying something in your education, then this will be a very good transit, because Jupiter will directly aspect the fifth house of intelligence, and it will definitely be very helpful in your education part. Jupiter will also aspect your 7th house of marital life, so it will give a very strong bonding between you and your spouse. It will try to protect your marriage. Even though Mars is getting debilitated, it is aspecting the 7th house by its 4th aspect, but still the benefic aspect of Jupiter will fall on the 7th house, and it will definitely bring some good results in your life. In your 10th house, Saturn is transiting in its retrograde motion, and here Saturn, since it is in retrograde motion, although it is in its own house, but still it will ask for lots and lots of commitment, discipline from your side. You have to be much more perseverant and endurant regarding your work. Means now you have to be very careful regarding what your boss or authority is wanting from you, what they are asking from you, what your superiors are expecting from you. Then you have to do those sort set of works in that particular manner. Because after when Saturn will turn retrograde, your hard work will get the payoff, you will get the payback, you will get the results. Because when Saturn will get direct, that time you will feel that yes, your life is much more easier than before. Although Mars will aspect the 10th house, it will oppose the 10th house. You see, Mars loses its digbal. Mars is your energy. Mars is the energy to do your actions, your efforts. It provides the insights to act and react depending upon the situation. So that energy is getting debilitated and also losing its digbal and opposing the 10th house. So that means now you have to be very much careful, much more, because there can be a chance that depending upon certain situations, you may oppose the decision of your boss or authority, or there can be some disputes or conflicts regarding any person working in your professional area or career, so which can lead to some problems. But since Saturn is getting retrograde, so you have to analyze the situation, that should you act in a very rude or harsh manner, or should you take the necessity of the situation and work in a much more committed manner, so that it can actually give you results much more better in the coming future. So this is the transits for the planets, for the people of Aries, and I hope these are the primary concerns which you will take care of, and ultimately when you take care of all these things, you are going to get a proper result.
So as you have seen, the general predictions which can be seen by the transit of planet in their respective signs for the sign of Aries. Hope you have liked this video. Tap onto the like button if you have really liked this video, and share it to your near and dear ones who you understand that who need to understand this video. And your comments are always welcome to me. Your precious opinions and queries, please write it down in the comment box. And if you want any time, any one-to-one consultation with me, then check the links in the description section. So till then, thanking you. Bye-bye.